Okay, so classification learning. Before we get into the details of that, I want to define a couple of terms because we're going to be throwing these terms out all throughout the lessons, and I want to make certain that we're all on the same page and we mean the same thing. We'll be returning to this again and again and again. So the first term I want to introduce is the notion of instances. So instances, or another way of thinking about them, is input. Those are vectors of value, of attributes, that define whatever your input space is. So they can be pictures and all the pixels that make up pictures, like we've been doing so far before. They can be credit score examples, like how much money I make, or how much money Michael makes, how much money I wish I made, so on and so forth. So whatever your input value is, whatever it is you're using to describe the input, whether it's pixels or it's discrete values, those are your instances, the set of things that you're looking at. So you have instances, that's the set of inputs that you have. And then what we're trying to find is some kind of function, and that is the concept that we care about. And this function actually maps inputs to outputs. So it takes the instances and maps them, in this case, to some kind of output, such as true or false. This is the category of the things that we're worried about. And for most of the conversation that we're going to be having, we're going to be thinking about binary classification, just true and false. But the truth is, this would work whether there were three outputs, as we did with high school, college, or grad school, or whether there were 250, as we were contemplating for ages. But the main thing here is the concept is the function that we care about that's going to map pictures, for example, to true or false.
So, okay, so I get the use of the word instance, right? An instance is just like a single thing that's out there.
Mm-hmm.
But I have an intuitive notion of what a concept is. How does that relate to this more formal notion? Like, can we connect this to kind of the intuitive notion of what a concept is?
I guess so. A concept, I don't know. What, how would you want to put that? So a concept is something that, I mean, we're talking about it as a notion of a function. So what it means formally is that you have some input, like a picture, and it immediately maps anything in that input space to some particular defined output space, like true or false, or male or female, or creditworthy or not. Intuitively, a concept is an idea that describes a set of things. Right? So we can talk about maleness or femaleness. We could talk about short and tall. We can talk about college students and grad students. And so the concept is the notion of what creditworthiness is, what a male is, what a college student is.
Okay, I think I see that. So essentially, if you want to think of tallness, the concept of tallness, one way to define it is to say, well, in general, I can, if you give me something, I can tell you whether or not it's tall. So it's going to map those somethings to, am I tall or not, true or false?
Right, exactly. And so really, when you think about any concept, I mean, and when we talk about this in general in AI, right, a concept is effectively a way of say, is effectively a set of things that are a part of that concept. So you can have a concept of a car, and if I gave you cars, you would say these things are in it, and if I gave you non-cars, you would say they are not. And so a concept is therefore, by definition, a mapping between objects in the world and membership in a set, which makes it a function.
Okay, that makes sense.
Okay.